Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations. Today I have the Gigabyte G493-ZB3 GPU Server, which is an NVIDIA certified system, and it is a performer. At 4U, it features dual AMD EPYC 9004 or 9005 series processors with up to 160 Zen 5 cores. Less cores if you go with 9004 series CPUs, but we will get to that. This is a large server with room for up to 8 GPUs and quite a bit of memory. Like our channel? Hit that subscribe button. If it's too early to tell, then let's get to it. As you know, AI is big in information technology right now, and the Gigabyte G493-ZB3 GPU server delivers an impressive set of features to tackle AI, AI training, AI inference, visual computing, and high-performance computing applications. With a 4U chassis, dual processors, support for up to 48 DIMM modules, and up to 8 double-wide PCI GPUs, it can deliver on that AI promise. Oh yes, it can. On the front of the system are 12 2.5-inch hot-swap storage bays that can be outfitted with SAS-4, SATA, and Gen 5 NVMe storage devices. There are two low-profile PCI Gen 5x16 slots on the front of the system, and a control panel at the bottom of the chassis with two USB 3.2 Gen 1 slots, a dedicated management port, VGA port, and two 1 gigabit Ethernet ports. Squeezed in between the RJ45 ports and the VGA port are a few LEDs and buttons, including a unit ID button, the power on button, both with integrated LED, next HDD LED, system status LED, then buttons for reset and non-maskable interrupt. Doing a little machine learning or AI training? Maybe you just need a high-performance computing unit. If yes is the answer to that random question, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off this Gigabyte G493-ZB3 GPU server that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just mention this video. If you want to learn more about the system, click that link. And as I said, when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video to reap the rewards. On the back of the system, there's not much. Four 3000-watt PSUs featuring 1+3 redundancy, and to the right you can see the PCI slots on the bottom for the GPUs, and a row of 8 PCI slots for low-profile PCI cards on top. That's it, as the control panel is located on the front of the system. That integrated management port provides access to Gigabyte's pre-installed management console. The Gigabyte management console is free of charge and accesses the ASPEED AST2600 management module installed on the system board. The management console will enable you to manage this single server or a small cluster. If you need more comprehensive management of several servers, say in a data center, then you can download the Gigabyte Server Management Suite. GSM is compatible with both IPMI and Redfish standards and includes several utilities to make life much easier for system admins. Once we lift off the cover panel, you can see the basic setup with the CPUs and memory modules staggered behind the 12 60mm fans just behind the drive backplane. With a staggered formation, there is a x4 PCI slot on each side for support of an M.2 drive, one on the side of CPU 0 and the other on the side of CPU 1. With just one M.2, you can boot the system. With two M.2 drives installed, you can boot the system with redundancy in a mirrored RAID for resilience. Where it gets interesting is with the GPUs. So let's start with that by lifting the lid, so to speak. That lid is comprised of 8 low-profile PCI slots and can be used for network communications or perhaps a SAS controller. The back slots tilt up to expose the full-height, full-length PCI 5.0 slots underneath where the double-wide GPUs can be installed. By the way, all slots are PCI 5.0x16 slots for full bandwidth. And now I'm thinking that maybe I should have talked about the processors first. As those CPUs support up to 128 PCI lanes per CPU, but only 160 PCI 5.0 lanes with both processors installed. I know you feel a little like you got shortchanged on that, but you didn't. I mean, there are 20 PCI x16 slots, not to mention the 2x4 M.2 slots. That adds up to more than 2 times the number of PCI 5.0 slots available from the CPUs. However, PCI switches connect to those low-profile PCI x16 slots on top, and then there's another set of PCI switches for the GPU board down below. The switches ensure an orderly and efficient stream of data from the CPU to the PCI devices both top and bottom, essentially increasing the overall bandwidth utilization. The front PCI switches are actually not in the switch loop and are directly under CPU control. On the bottom, you do have a few choices for GPU support from AMD, NVIDIA, Xilinx, and Qualcomm. From AMD, there's only the Instinct MI210 with 64 gigabytes of HBM2E memory and 6,656 processor cores. There are more NVIDIA GPU options that are qualified to run on this system, including the NVIDIA A100, H100, H100NVL, L40, and L40S. For graphics-intensive applications, the NVIDIA RTX 6080 generation. The real standouts here for AI applications are the H100 NVL with 94 gigabytes of memory and the H100 with up to 80 gigabytes of HMB3 memory. Both feature Hopper architecture with the H100 NVL given slight edge with support for more memory and a dual GPU design that supports NVL link connectivity for greater memory bandwidth than the H100. On top, and I suppose in front, you can install a choice of network controllers and hard drive controllers for RAID or HBA. You'll still need a controller if you want SAS drives. You can also choose an NVIDIA BlueField 2 DPU card to improve the efficiency of your network communications. It does that by offloading some of the traffic that would ordinarily go through the CPU and is fully programmable. Some of these are very fast, but Gigabyte only mentions one with an SFP56 interface on a Gen 5 PCI x8 card with dual ports at 25 gigabits per second per port. No worries, there are other options with faster network communication speeds. Dual CPUs are supported on the system. If you want access to all the memory, storage, and PCI slots, then both CPUs are required. Otherwise, you're half full of everything. And who wants that with something like this? I suppose you can still get the management features too with only CPU 0 installed. But again, why? So dual sockets compatible with 4th and 5th generation AMD EPYC processors. Originally, it only supported 4th gen CPUs, but with Rev 3, you get support for 5th gen CPUs. 4th gen CPUs will provide up to 128 cores and 256 threads per CPU, compared to up to 160 cores and 320 threads with 5th gen AMD EPYCs. Yes, 5th gen will go up to 192 physical cores and 384 virtual threads, but the thermal design power rating on this system is limited to 400 watts per CPU, so you won't be able to install the 192 core top of the line 5th gen CPU, as that one has a TDP of 500 watts. Still, at 160 cores and 320 virtual threads per CPU, quite impressive. The 4th gen EPYCs top out at 360 watts, so not a problem with TDP across the family. That said, depending on your workload, or maybe, more importantly, in the short run, your budget, you may not need all those cores. 5th gen CPUs actually go from 8 cores up to 160 cores, physical cores. Double that for virtual cores. With 4th gen, you get 16 cores up to 128 cores with the 9754S and the 9754. All of these CPUs deliver 12-channel memory architecture and support up to 24 DDR5 RDIMMs per socket. Memory speed is limited to 4800 megatrans per second with one DIMM per channel with 5th gen CPUs, or up to 4400 megatrans per second with 4th gen CPUs. Memory speed will be reduced with two DIMMs per channel. At full capacity with 256 gigabyte modules in all slots, this system can support up to 12 terabytes of memory. I do hope you enjoyed the short overview of the Gigabyte G493-ZB3 GPU server. With dual 5th gen AMD EPYC CPUs, full complement of memory, and 8 high performance GPUs installed, you're good to go on a number of high performance computing scenarios or AI applications. Tried to make this brief given my tendency for too much information, but if you have any questions, post them in the comment section below. If you are looking for one of these behemoths of computational power, then I placed a few links below, or you can click that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stewart with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.